Hello, lovelies. I'm Christina, and today, in the spirit of Nonfiction November, I'm going to show you the books that I have that are nonfiction that I'm most excited to get to. Now, I don't expect to get to a lot of nonfiction in November because I am doing NaNoWriMo, and doing that plus a lot of other projects going on at the same time, there won't be a lot of time for reading, but hopefully there will be some. So let's jump into the nonfiction books that I want to get to. The first one is one that I've already started to listen to on Audible, and that is The Story of World War II by Donald L. Miller. This is really what the title says. It is the story of World War II told from the perspectives of many different people, from civilians to journalists to people who fought in the war, and he's put this all together in this massive book. Well, I'm listening to it, and it is right under 25 hours long, so I'm guessing in a physical book it is quite a chunker. But as you know, I am a big World War II fanatic. I want to know as much as I can, both when it comes to fiction and nonfiction, and I just love getting into it. I think it's horrible, but so super important to know what happened and how it happened. And this really gives me insight to a lot of the things that happened during the war. While we are on the subject of World War II, I have another one as well. And that is The Last Days of Hitler by Hugh Trevor Roper. So this tells the story of the last days of the war and the last days in the life of Hitler. So Hitler is a personality that just fascinates me and scares me at the same time, because it is just truly terrifying how someone who gets to power and has this very charismatic personality, or just knows how to manipulate or get around people and get them to listen and focuses on fear, how they can get to a position of power like this and turn it into a world war. I'm very interested to get a bit of a more insight into the last days of his life. Then we're getting into science, and the next one is Parallel Worlds, A Journey Through Creation, Higher Dimensions, and the Future of the Cosmos by Michio Kaku. Now, Kaku is a physicist, and this book revolves around parallel worlds and the string theory. This is something that I find to be super, super interesting, and I've heard amazing things about Kaku as a writer, but I haven't read any of his stuff yet, so I'm very intrigued by this, and I can't wait to listen to it on my Audible. And what do you know, Stephen King, he sneaks his way into this video as well. And it is not On Writing, because I have read that one and I loved it. But this time around, it is Danse Macabre by Stephen King. And this is Stephen King going through how horror has been in popular culture through TV, movies, books. It says, Danse Macabre ranges across the whole spectrum of horror in popular culture, from the seminal classics of Dracula and Frankenstein. It is a charming and fascinating book, replete with pertinent anecdote and observation, in which Stephen King describes his ideas on how horror works on many levels and how he brings it to bear on his own inimitable novels. So I've had this one on my shelf for a long time, and it is quite a chunker, but I wanted to get to this for so long, so I'm guessing it's time. And because I am writing my own kind of horror fantasy novel during NaNoWriMo, that makes me want to read this even more right now. Now over to psychology, and the next one is The Autistic Spectrum by Lorna Wing. I mentioned this in my haul where I showed this as well. It says the new and updated edition, but this edition came out in 2002, so there might be newer and more updated editions than this one. I haven't checked, but still, I'm very curious to know more about the autistic spectrum. And the last nonfiction book I have here kind of goes around the subject of psychology as well. Lately, I've been watching I Am a Killer on Netflix, which is super fascinating. I highly recommend it. Every episode tells the story of someone who is on death row convicted of murder. And it just gives you this really detailed insight into what they are thinking and how other people perceive them and their thoughts around death row and meeting their sentence. It's fascinating. You should check it out. But because of that, I've been thinking a lot about this book as well, because I've had this one on my shelf for years too. And it is Birdman, The Many Faces of Robert Stroud by Jolene Babiak. Now, Birdman, he was a bird scientist that cured a lot of bird diseases, but he is also portrayed as this psychopathic murderer. It says, with quotes from prisoners and officers who knew him, psychologists and avian pathologists, with comments from his files and his own writings, Birdman challenges the myths surrounding Robert Stroud. I bought this book when I visited Alcatraz myself, and it was during that audio tour that I did on Alcatraz that sparked my interest for Robert Stroud, and I got this. It is also signed by the author who was there at the same time. So this is one that I've had on my shelf for a long time. I've been wanting to read it, but haven't gotten to it yet. Hopefully soon. So that is it, guys. Those are a few of the non-fiction reads that I'm most excited to get to and hopefully will pretty soon. Let me know in the comments down below if you have any favorites when it comes to non-fiction, or if there is a non-fiction book that you're just dying to get to. There will be links to all of the books in the thingamajiggy down below. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And I will see you in my next video soon. Goodbye!